guys, it's Sarah and welcome back to a new video. And today I'm going to be doing a makeup review that I'm really excited to do just because it's a brand that I've been keeping my eye on for such a long time, but I haven't had the good chance or timing to actually purchase them and try it out because it is quite on the higher end for a Korean beauty brand. But I did pick up two products from Pony Effect. I really wanted to try these, so I gave in and eventually purchased that during my birthday a few weeks ago. So the two products I'll be reviewing today are the Pony Effect Waterproof Cushion Foundation Stick and the Stay Fit Matte Lip Colors. So these are the two products that I bought, and I do have them on my face today, so you know, I'll show you guys demos in this review while I do talk about it and all that, so let's get started. First off, before I get on with the review, my camera is a very old DSLR camera, and I do mention that every now and then, but this is going to be really unfortunate because this camera will not do justice for any of these like reviews that I really wanted to show these guys, so these guys will just have to trust me with what I will tell you based on my experience and my first impression on it. So onto the Waterproof Cushion Foundation Stick. This is actually still quite new. This came out during the summer season in Korea, so it's still kind of summer there, I believe. But it is fairly new, and I really wanted to get my hands on it rather than the actual cushions because this was quite intriguing. And looking online, there's not a lot of English kind of information about it, so I'm really gonna have to just have to, like, you know, talk about it based on my experience. So I'm sorry about that because I don't really read Korean, so I can't really say what the benefits are because I don't see any English translations or versions of it. So yeah. So as for this foundation stick, there are actually 5 shades. This shade that I purchased is pretty much 24 or 25, so it's the darkest shade, and this is in the shade number, or in the shade sand, so it's the darkest shade that they have available. As for the packaging, it's very unique. They do call it a cushion stick foundation, and I find it really intriguing because it's not an actual stick, it's a liquid that's in a package of a stick, and it also comes with a little cushion tip that you use as the applicator to kind of apply the foundation. And over here, where you place your index finger, is where you just pump to dispense the actual foundation onto the cushion. And at the bottom, you do have a brush that's quite dense, and I'll talk about this during the application a little later. The formula, and just like its name, this is meant to be a waterproof foundation, so perfect for the summer, perfect for those with, I would honestly say, oily skin as well. It is kind of more on the matte side, so it works great for those with oily skin tones. The consistency of the actual foundation, which I have swatched right here on the back of my hand, it is quite lightweight. The coverage is actually really nice. I'd say rather than a full coverage, I would consider it as a medium to a buildable full coverage. Now onto the application, like I said, you would pump the actual product out onto the cushion tip, and then you would just pretty much slide this along your face. So my first time trying this product out, I did try without primer, just moisturizer. It actually works pretty well without a primer, but this time round I actually had my skin prepped just how I usually would with primer and apply this on, and it still performs exactly the same. It glides on really smoothly onto the skin, and for blending out, all you have to do is use the brush and just kind of buff it, or rather than buffing it in circular motion, I like to kind of just drag it downwards while kind of patting it, and that kind of application step style. But yes, it does blend out very nicely, and it doesn't lose its coverage, like it doesn't sheer out at all, it stays its exact kind of coverage. And with this brush, you'd kind of feel like it's not going to perform that great because it's just part of the actual foundation packaging, but it actually works really nicely with the foundation. It buffs the product out and lets it apply really nicely onto the skin. Even without primer, it kind of blurs out your complexion and your pores, and I actually like that. It sits onto the skin very nicely. And also, as for the cushion tip, at first I did kind of consider it quite small and a little bit confusing because it is a very tiny applicator, but it really gets around, you know, every little corners around your face, and I actually really like that now because, you know, although you think at first you'd have to just depend on this to apply it, there's a brush along with it, so this just really gets it more crisp, like with the application. You'll see in the demo, I actually had my brows and my eyes done, so I was able to get around those areas without getting any foundation on it, and I really like that. And as for the longevity of this, it's kind of hard to judge. As for the meantime, because it is winter here, so I guess I will have to try it out during the summertime, and I'll just give you guys updates about that. It's a very comfortable kind of medium to full coverage foundation that lasts throughout the day, so you don't really feel any makeup on your face, and it just doesn't feel drying, so I really like that because right now I shouldn't be using this because my skin is very dry in the winter time, but it still works quite well and it's not too over drying on my skin. So I think when I test this out in the summertime, it will work nicely. We'll just have to see about the shade, so fingers crossed about that. Now on to the Pony FX Stay Fit Matte Lip Color. I got this in the shade Exquisite, and this is one of the Pony FX products that I really wanted to try out. I try really hard to avoid these, but I couldn't resist because they added 3 new colors, and this is one of them, and it's kind of a pink mauve-y with a little tint of kind of purple in it, and this is a kind of color that I would definitely go for as a bold lip color for my skin tone. I know that's not bold to some people, but to me it's like a very wearable statement kind of makeup focal point, if that makes sense. I don't know if my camera will do justice once again, so I do apologize for that, but I'm actually really liking this a lot. So in terms of application, it's really easy. The way I would apply this, I would always start with the upper lip first and kind of focus on the cupid's bow and kind of shaping and perfecting that. So I kind of do that outline with a little X in the center of the upper lip, and then I will just line the rest of my lips and then fill it in with the product that's still on the actual felt tip brush. And I actually coat my lips quite thinly with this lipstick because going too thick will just really cause a lot of cracking. And yeah, I mean, this is very, very comfortable, and just like its name, Stay Fit, it sits well. Okay, you really have to prep your lips first of all, but it sits in the lips nicely, it's very comfortable, and it's not drying whatsoever. And I always have dry lips, but this is very comfortable for me, so I would definitely recommend anyone to try any of these Pony FX Stay Fit Matte Lip Colors because they're really nice, and you do have quite a decent shade kind of selections, from, you know, neutrals to nudes to darks. So I would definitely recommend for you guys to check that out. And yeah, I mean, I just really like these, and I'm hoping that I could get my hands on more when I do visit Korea at the end of the year, so very excited for that. So overall, I'm actually really, really impressed with both of these products. The application, the first impression, and the experience of using this was very, very nice. Why am I repeating my words? But it was really good, and I really didn't want to like Pony FX because it is on the pricier side, but now trying it, I totally see why Eddie or Edward or Villa actually really likes this. The packaging is cute as well, and there's just so many products that I want to try from Pony FX, but I'll wait until I finally get there at the end of the year so I can actually swatch it and try it out myself rather than just spending on it online and not actually liking it. So we'll see how that goes later in the future. And just before I conclude this, I do use this with one layer like application, and for more coverage I would use my Clio Kill Cover Concealer just for some more coverage on some dark spots and acne scars. So that's pretty much how I do the full face kind of coverage makeup. And yeah, I mean, this is my go-to makeup for the past 4 days, and 4 days. I've only been trying this out for 4 days, but I'm actually really impressed. I was gonna do a first impression on these, but once I got my package, I couldn't control myself, so I just tried it out behind camera or off camera, and you know, kind of had some, you know, I just needed to prepare myself for this review since there wasn't any English information online. So yeah, I know, I feel like this won't be informative as a Korean review on these, but this is the best I could do, so I hope you guys don't mind. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review, and let me know what you guys think. If you have any questions, comment down below. Social media and all that. Oh, I still have to catch up on my blog, so I do apologize for that, but I'm getting there, and yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.